After completing a degree in English literature and philosophy, I did a master's in journalism. I wanted to highlight stories that were generally ignored and that nobody talked about. I made films for BBC and Channel 4 in the UK, and then in Pakistan on humanitarian topics that weren't really highlighted. One of the biggest stories that shook me was when I stumbled upon the intense connection between child sexual abuse and heroin addiction in Peshawar. Spending so much time talking to pedophiles as young as 10 years old, heroin addicts who were 5 years old, prostituting themselves, and the men who raped them, I realized the missing link, the obvious gap in our country that is completely ignored, is empathy. No one knows what empathy and compassion actually is. By this time, I started another degree in humanistic psychotherapy and specialized in working with kids so I could really get to the root of this issue. I realized I didn't just want to report on the stories, I wanted to be on the front lines to change the stories. And that's how ACF came about. The vision being to help and empower those who have been completely neglected and forgotten by society. And of course, I had to start with animals because nothing has ever been done for them since Pakistan's inception. There are millions of dogs and cats and hundreds of thousands of donkeys that we see on the road every day being tortured, abused, in agony. But no one looks. No one cares. We have become immune to suffering and have forgotten basic kindness, which is to do something for those who cannot give you anything in return. So I started the first rescue ambulance, sanctuary, shelter, and hospital for street and working animals so they can have some dignity and some rights, and used social media to start spreading my message of kindness. I started with only one volunteer vet and myself, and today, after 6 years of overcoming so many difficulties, changing mindsets and explaining why this is so important, we have 45 staff members, a sanctuary that houses over 500 animals at a time, and we have rescued over 5,000 animals. From having acid and boiling water thrown on cats, to having the tail and ears of a dog cut off, to hanging a dog from a telephone pole, and to poisoning and shooting dogs, to mercilessly torturing donkeys, the severity of animal abuse we have discovered that goes on in Pakistan is shocking and disturbing to a whole other level. We are breeding violence, and that had to be highlighted. From 50 followers on Facebook, we organically went up to over 60,000 die-hard supporters. A movement of animal rights and kindness started in Pakistan 6 years ago with ACF, and society is changing for the better. We go into slums and help donkey owners by providing free medical treatment, food and water to their animal. That is their only source of making a living. We also try to explain that helping the animal and not beating him will help them in the long run. Donkeys are tortured, made to bleed and run on broken legs, given no food and water for days when carrying tons of weight. Pakistan is one of the largest donkey-populated countries in the world, yet there is nothing being done for them. Donkey owners are one of the largest segments of daily wages, but there's no one to support them. We are trying to cover that gap. We also work in the forgotten brick kilns in Punjab, where bonded slave labor is still a norm and there's no support. And children, adults, and the animals are made to work long, exhausting hours for next to nothing and treated so brutally. There's no medical facility available to people working in the kilns. Children are covered in gangrene, tuberculosis, eye infection, throat infections is so common amongst other diseases. So we started a human medical camp side by side to our donkey camps and provide free treatment to people in those areas also. We have a small team who work non-stop, and the results have been phenomenal. We took our work a step further to give our work a holistic approach. We cover animals, humans, and the environment together. It was this three-dimensional model that won us the WWF Green Innovation Challenge in 2019. we created an eco-friendly dog leash made out of 100% ghost net, the plastic net that inundates the oceans and kills marine animals. By incentivizing fishermen to extract ghost net, we then trained and empowered women in impoverished fishing villages to braid the net into rope and then have our in-house team adorn it with colorful yarn. This was our first business model, 50% of the funds generated going to the fishing villages and the other half back into our foundation. It's a win-win all around. We followed the same model to teach donkey owners to make humane plastic harnesses for donkeys out of plastic sacks in which fruits and vegetables are sold. The current harnesses in the market are made of rough, coarse material with nails in it because the age-old belief is that the more you torture a donkey, the more he will work. Raw material that we use doesn't cost a thing, and we aim to equip them with a new skill to benefit the donkey owners and the animal in the long run. We also teach them about donkey behavior and how to get the work out of their animal without violence, which then won us another grant from the Donkey Sanctuary in the UK. My team and I went to Nepal for a training with them and then carried out the first official National Equine Assessment Survey in Pakistan in the hopes of understanding the situation to improve it. The work we do is rooted in thinking forward and adhering to a bigger vision of trying to make empathy a norm in our culture. In the 6 years I've been working with animals, I have learned more about human behavior than when I was a therapist or journalist. Empathy and violence are two sides of the same coin. If we can bring about a switch and people can learn to be more empathic towards the most vulnerable, they will learn to be more compassionate overall and to each other. Animal cruelty is the first indicator of more abuse on the line, like domestic violence, sexual abuse, physical abuse, and bullying. If one cannot learn to be kinder to the most powerless of living beings and exert violent power instead, our country cannot improve morally or otherwise. This is not a westernized concept, but a civilized one. I aim on working on the cause of the problem, not the symptoms. We run empathy education programs in schools, and kids from private and public schools, specially abled children, those who have been through severe drug addiction and sexual abuse, and acid burn survivors visit us. Animals have a way of healing trauma by providing a non-judgmental space, and that's what our sanctuary has now become, a platform of compassion, and the impact has been astounding. I had hired one of my therapy clients, an acid burn survivor, to work for the shelter because she was being exploited and paid next to nothing, and people just stared at her like she was a monster. Her husband had poured 4 bottles of acid on her head. She didn't have an eye or an ear or hair, and she was covered in layers of cloth so no one saw her. However, in 3 months of working with us, she made the most remarkable transformation. Removed the layers, wore our cap and our shirt, and said that animals don't see what's on the outside. They don't judge. They provided to her the purest reflection back, which had been robbed from her by her own traumatic experiences and other people. The question I get the most often is, why are you helping animals and not people? These are the types of stories that explain that the work we do has effects so far-reaching, it is incredible. Why do we have to decide who to be kind to? Why does kindness have to come with conditions attached to it? It doesn't take anything away from a person to be kind to an animal. In fact, it just makes us more humble and caring. A few examples now of how our work has impacted so many people.
मेरा नाम शीमा खान है। बचपन से मुझे मेरी कमर में प्रॉब्लम है जिसका नाम डायस्टोमेटामेली है। जब मैं बाहर जाती थी तो लोग मुझे देखते थे मेरी प्रॉब्लम की वजह से और मुझे ऐसा फील करवाते थे कि जैसे मैं अपनी लाइफ में कभी आगे नहीं बढ़ सकती। उनकी नज़रों में मुझे अपने लिए सिंपथी नज़र आती थी जो मुझे कभी पसंद नहीं आई। जब मैं ACF में आई तो मुझे कभी नहीं लगा था कि मैं डॉग्स के साथ या बड़े किसी भी जानवर के साथ काम कर सकती हूँ। पर वक्त के साथ और एनिमल्स में रहकर मुझ में एक कॉन्फिडेंस आया। एनिमल्स ने मुझे मेरी लाइफ के मीनिंग सिखाए और आज मुझे ऐसा फील होता है कि मैं अपनी लाइफ में कुछ भी कर सकती हूँ। मेरे एनिमल्स ने मुझे कभी जज नहीं किया। उन्होंने मुझे प्यार किया विथ ऑल प्योरिटी। आज मुझे मेरी फिजिकल कंडीशन से कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, मैं अपनी लाइफ में बहुत पॉजिटिव और मोटिवेटेड हूँ, और ये सब कुछ मेरे एनिमल्स की वजह से, एंड आई एम वेरी थैंकफुल ऑफ दैट।
क्योंकि मेरा फर्ज है, अगर एक जानवर बेजबान है, हमने कुछ किया तो वो कितना, उसको कितना तकलीफ होती है, कि हमारा को पता नहीं है, वो जानवरों को पता है। जब हमारा को गोली वगैरह या कुछ छोटे से भी चोट लग जाते हम रोने लग जाते, तो बिल्ली कैसे रोते होगी? बिल्ली का भी तो दिल है ना यार, बिल्ली का भी तो अकल है, जबान भी अकल तो है ना।
ये तो सही बात,
हमारा तो फिर दोनों चीज़ें, जबान भी, अकल भी है, जहन भी है।
My name is Nadal Adana Hadish, and I am an ambassador for the ACF Animal Rescue on the streets of Pakistan. There are many animals in need, and ACF endeavors to help them all. Whether there was a dog in a wheelchair, just like me, and it was really awesome. It is important to look after animals because they have feelings too. So consider supporting them on Twitter and all over the world. I hope you like it. Goodbye and good night to you all.